Iconic images of East London, captured by an iconic EastEnder. This is David Bailey's snapshot, taken over 50 years, of the storied neighbourhood in which he was born and raised. Because this is a picture that really stands out. I mean, nowhere but England, right?
Yeah.
Nowhere but England and the East End.
They're great, aren't they? She's probably only about 19.
Through the faces and streetscapes of East London, Bailey's new exhibition tells a tale of life amid poverty, crime and the rubble of war. How old were you when you took that? And what do you remember?
I guess I was around about 22, 23. It was kind of Proustian in a way, because that was my playground, those bomb sites. And then I don't feel sorry for myself. It was perfectly okay because you didn't know any different. And from the age of about 3 and a half to probably 2 years after the war, the sound I remember most is walking on broken glass. I mean, again, I liked it. I loved jumping on someone's broken window in a bomb site. But everywhere you went, there was the crunch of broken glass, and it's the soundtrack to my life.
What are your endearing memories?
Of the East End?
Mm.
I mean, there was no expectations, really. I didn't have expectations. I knew I was an artist, in a way, because all I did as a kid was draw, because I'm really badly dyslexic. And, you know, people that say, oh, that's a good get out, they don't know the misery I had at school, because I used to get caned because I couldn't spell. It wasn't... Now people expect too much because governments have told them they can have everything. But we accepted the way things are, but had the persistence to try to move on.
What Bailey lacked in reading skills, he made up for with a keen eye and charisma. Models, movie stars, rock legends and crime bosses have all sought out his lens, including the infamous Cray brothers, who shared his East End stomping ground.
This is a gambling club that belonged to Reg and Ron.
The Crays.
Yeah, and that was firebombed 10 minutes after we left. And this is another one. This was the Rio Club. And Checo, the Reg used to give me as my minder. He used to, when I was down there, he used to give me someone to look after me.
You knew all these guys, right?
Yeah, Checo. I helped him escape from the police. God, I'm going to get in trouble for that. I gave him 350 quid to disappear.
When was that? What, 1965 or something?
68 or something. But he was a good guy, Checo. He was a nice guy. He kind of gentle giant.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, someone didn't want to be photographed, he'd grab them and say, all right, Dave, you can take their picture. I say, Checker, it's not quite the picture I'm after.
Today, this is the kind of picture Bailey is capturing in the East End.
This is good. This is what it's now become. You know, this kind of colourful, kind of bit of mystery, because you can't see their faces. And walking away as two Essex girls, you know, with a tight skirt and the... So this is kind of, for me, the slow change of things.
More multicultural the district may be, but it's remained a neglected part of London until recently. As the hub for the 2012 Olympics, it's been undergoing a major transformation.
What do you think of the regeneration of the area?
At least it's a positive move. I mean, people say, oh, will it be any... There's always the pessimists, but let's just... It changed things, and change is good, and change is the way things move on. If you don't have change, you don't move on, really.
Becky Anderson, CNN, London.